went too low, no, I need my leg. Coach, please sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone, I'm on to a default. This ain't come from the league, I got money, take care of mass. Ride to the wheels, don't crash. And I hit whoever, long as we get past. Take it back to pale touchdown. Whoever thought.
Start me up, I got finishing moves. Look, salute when you see me. It's the real ones can vouch, they thought I was done. But all that out, you gotta pay my nigga this hard. Salute when you see me. Put in the car.
Wow, can you believe it? This kid just did the impossible.
And salute when you see me.
I'm just getting started.
Boom. Love that closing line. So, what you think?
Yo, you absolutely crushed it. This final edit really took it to the next level, man. I mean, you gotta be looking for an agency job, bro.
I'm glad we're on the same page, man. There's gonna be a lot of eyes on this. Just gonna be ready for when you make it big.
What? With all the subs you're about to get?
I mean, we've been boys for a minute, but I ain't that nice.
You gotta talk to my agent.
Yeah, we just pulled in. Uh-huh, filled in. All right, great. We'll be right there.
Yo, this place is amazing. One day, I'm gonna have my own building. Banners hanging up.
You a beast on the field, man. It's only a matter of time. And I know you gonna get both. We just need the banner to be dope. Oh, like that one, you know, with the shoulder pads and the baseball bat.
Love that.
Well, you know, you gotta let your man take care of that, because, you know, Zono swag.
Yeah, you do. Man, it's chilly out here.
Hey, yo, Jay, since we're early, can we stop here real quick? This would be a perfect spot for a video.
Always cutting it so close, huh? All right, 2 minutes.
All right, you ready, baby Creed?
Yeah, man, let's go.
All right, what's up, y'all? I gotta ask my man, what are we doing here at Nike HQ?
Hey, so I got an exclusive invite to come out here and train with some of the best in the NFL. Just to be here and learn from these vets far into the league is It's huge for me. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, but I'm ready. Let's go.
Money. Nailed it, baby.
Cool. Thanks again, Jordan. I still can't believe we're here.
You got this. Now let's go get...
Let's go get it.
Fellas,
how are you
doing? Good. Everyone's nice and excited. I don't look so nervous. Everyone's happy. Good. You all had your breakfast, I hope. Hard training this morning, boys. Hey, buddy, how are ya? Alrighty, guys. Long speeches aren't my thing, so I'm gonna keep this brief. This is gonna be 6 weeks with no interruptions. 6 days a week, 2 sessions a day. The thing that separates the elite athletes is the work that they do during the off season. We're gonna improve your stamina, your strength, speed, and agility. But it's not just about the physical reps or the high intensity with the technical work. It's about the mental, the nutrition, and the recovery. Welcome to the program. Alrighty, fellas, I'll see you out there in a bit, yeah?
Oh, all right, I guess I'll go ahead and back in. Oh, that's how you do it? Oh, he's running that way. Oh, okay. It's a little wobbly there, like a duck. I don't know. Makes his cut, press and release the icon. Is that not what I did? I thought that, Jesus Christ, I did it 3 times in the fucking row. Even though we buy a chain, we just want to be free. I don't want to be judged, I just want to be me. Nola 7-8. You got to be the one the people looking up to. I tried to reach the sun, but got me stuck to my shoes. You got to be the one the people looking up to. I tried to reach the sun, but got me stuck to my shoes. I'm only human. I'm not perfect, just a person. I'm only human. Sometimes happy, sometimes nervous. I'm only human. I'm not perfect. Is that a foul?
Come on, set! 79 runs!
What? There, he's open. I don't know what more you want from me. He's open. He ran into you. I don't know what else I'm supposed to do, man. Probably failed that. I don't know if I believe it.
This is the Rich Eisen.
Excuse me already, but let's get it then. What? I'm all about it, the extra work, coach. Let's fucking get the fit.
What? Mm. Let's see what we can do.
Brandon, hey, Jordan Wright, we met last week.
Hey, Jordan. Everyone's talking about you and your client. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. Listen, I know you're busy, but could you give me some intel on how you feel he's doing?
Still in the early phases of development. We just got to rewire his system a little bit so we can get the best performance out of him.
I see. Anything that stands out the most?
Loves to compete. Loves it. He wants to win every drill, every time.
Sounds about right.
But I'm just fine-tuning a few things with him so he can get those results.
Hey, so listen.
I was here to play.
Second week of training here at Nike is in the books, and my man is putting in some extra work on his own because that is how you stay a household.
Oof. And he dropped it? How is that my fault? Zero for three. Oh, that doesn't help at all. Definitely trash now.
Hey, man, it's all good. Don't get down on yourself. All right, think about it. When you get to the NFL, you're going to have a whole week to prep for these matchups. So if you put in work in the film room, you're going to be on an even playing field. No doubt.
Not the point. I should be ready already. I'm the face of the franchise. Fuck everybody else in the week of preparation.
All right, so here's.
Shit, let's get it. Let's get it, let's get it, let's get it.
If you haven't heard the name Jordan Wright yet, believe me, you're about to be hearing it a whole lot real soon. She's one of the top young agents in the game. And we're
my name, not her name. Fuck her name.
Descended upon this grand palace, the Superdome in New Orleans. Tonight, it's the second of our two semifinal matchups in the college football playoffs. As we'll see the Oklahoma Sooners
taking on the
Nebraska Cornhuskers.
Put your helmet on, bitch. You ain't special. There you go, headbutt him with no helmet on. That's fucking smart. Now you got a concussion, can't even play.
And for the right to play in next Monday's national championship game in Miami, we are underway here in New Orleans. This fielded right at the goal line. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
Let's give it a little razzle-dazzle, boys.
On first and 10, Sellers dancing to his left. That one caught by Carter.
Oh, yeah, first down.
Big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A big connection on that one, 34 yards. On first down. Sellers sliding out of the pocket, but he's got his target, Harris.
Touchdown!
And he will score. Touchdown, Nebraska. Mitchell Harris, 39 yards. And the Cornhuskers, on just two plays, have taken the lead. Point after, right down the middle. It's now a 7-0 game. Nebraska now after the touchdown, back out to kick it away.
Chicken
and
shit.
There will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn
into a
pressure. Comes and down he goes. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
Well, here's what having mobility sometimes can work against you as a quarterback. He thinks he can retreat and outrun the pressure. But that time, they zeroed in on him.
Got him again!
Pressure, they got him again. The defense coming through on third down. A loss of 7 to bring him forward. Now Oklahoma's punter out there getting set as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10. Right at the 50-yard line. Rolling to his right. And it'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about.
The fucking child holds a mother.
So a P.I. call going to cost him there defensively. What did you see?
Well, I think it's the right call, partner, because sometimes we'll see officials kind of let him play. But by the letter of the law, it's definitely a penalty.
Oh, no!
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off at the 17. As a coach, this is what keeps you up at night in the days leading up to this semifinal. You worry about the turnovers, and that's his first INT.
You're supposed to dwell on the positive, but you're exactly right. We don't know a coach out there that doesn't worry about what can go wrong, and this really shouldn't be a surprise. We knew they'd throw the kitchen sink at him defensively. Pressure, a lot of disguises and coverages. He's got a lot to wade through in this game.
And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back.
Jump.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
Like half jump.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. To throw is Gilbert. He finds his man, complete. It's Chandler. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. On second down, they run with Stewart. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. Here's Gilbert.
That's all.
It's intercepted. It is. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. Well, he had to fit that into a
pretty tight window over the middle. And Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes you're fooled by the type of zone that he sees. Because oftentimes those linebackers will vacate and run downfield with receivers. In this case, he played a pure zone and was in the wrong spot for the QB.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
A nice throw right there, Charles. And what a season this young man's had at the quarterback position. 44 touchdown passes, just the 6 interceptions. You'd have to think,
and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Throwing on first down. Sellers. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second. Back to throw. Sellers. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get 3 before half. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt.
Yo!
And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And the lead moves to 10-0. The winner goes on, the loser goes home as we start the second half of this semifinal matchup. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. The Sooner offense back out, ready for their next possession. The result's not great thus far. A punt on the first drive and an interception last time out.
And let's face it, every team wants to come out on the field and play with some confidence, play with some tempo, play with some rhythm. And when you're making those types of mistakes, you're not getting any of that put together.
So what do you say, time to get back to the basics for them?
In a lot of ways, yes. But the biggest one, of course, is finding people who will take care of the football and make a few plays. You've got to have a drive now that calms down the entire team.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Why did he tackle? Why did he jump backwards on the tackle? What the fuck was that?
There are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yep.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 42.
They're not even trying to do anything.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He didn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there.
Extra point right down the middle, and that makes our score 17-0. So they throw the pick six, they'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Out is the Oklahoma offense ready for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback on the expected passing situation.
Oh, I'm going to look like
and
a goddamn,
good job
I don't know.
Defensively, they stop him short of the first at the 32. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. Now Oklahoma's punter out there getting set as he'll punt it away for the second time. taken in at the 22. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. He'll buy some time right. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Damn, I hit him in the worst spot possible.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Third down, Foster, and he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. We have played three quarters. Back now here on EA Sports, as we've got the final quarter upon us, we get ready to start the fourth. Fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And a fair catch taken here right at about the 40-yard line. And pretty woeful there, just 23 yards on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Sooner offense back out, ready for their next possession. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
To throw again on second down. Gilbert under pressure, and down he goes. It'll go as a loss of about six, and now it brings up third.
Well, remember, he had the interception earlier. Now he adds the sack. He's really making his presence felt out there.
Well, he is putting together a heck of a game. In fact, he's going to bump these plays to his highlight reel. Okay, so when he wants to show it off later on, look what I did out there, guys. And this offense, they've got to start paying him a little special attention. He's like a good basketball player, putting stats in every column.
That's into the hands of Edwards. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done.
I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Now a dump off here complete. And the result here, a pickup of eight.
This being the last 2 minutes, everything that happened.
Now Gilbert, that'll give him eight that time. And that'll bring up second down. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. Okay, it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is for. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
Gilbert.
And
this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Sooner touchdown. Jamon Mason, 29 yards. And the Sooners are finally into the end zone here this fourth quarter. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing. Out of the gun, they hand to Foster. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Now a second timeout called for by the defense, as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. And now Carter.
Wow!
Let me get tripped on the fucking blade of grass.
Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout, as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Flushed out right.
Run it. Get the first down.
And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Well, we know how important it is, Charles, that a quarterback can take off and run with it.
We're going to the championship.
This is a great job right here.
And he just exhibited what he's shown throughout his career.
Just to make sure
the reasons why they like him so much in today's football. His ability to use his feet and get out of trouble or create. His legs are going to be a big part of his game as he moves on. In fact, before the game, I talked with a veteran scout. He just told me, I never thought I'd write in my book about a quarterback who's mobile that I would like this much. He likes pocket guys from the past, but the way the game's going now, this guy, he's the future.
So let.
Let's go in a natty. Let's go get it.
Well, some of the biggest stars of the college football world will be on display tonight as we welcome you to Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Tonight we play for the College Football Playoffs National Championship, as we'll see the Clemson Tigers taking on the Nebraska Cornhuskers. South Florida, strap in, folks. It's going to be a good one, and we are underway in the national championship game. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. On first and 10, Sellers completes it to Dixon. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. So mark off the yardage for roughing the passer.
And I've seen this before. On a screen pass, not only are you rushing the passer, you're rushing him deeper than normal. And I think a little frustration kicks in at the end. You're going to hit him anyway when you shouldn't.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Operating from the gun. Sellers eluding the pressure right. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play and gave up a bigger one instead.
Steps away. And quick throw here. That's complete.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, it was flushed to his left.
Second and just about a few
Stop.
Somewhat manageable now, not so manageable.
Exactly, because you had a play call on that you felt like, hey, this could go quick, and it doesn't take much to get it done. Now, you got to start thinking about a little bit of a deeper route type of a call, especially if you want to
throw it. And he'll lose yardage, brought down at the 32. That'll be a loss of two on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down. So the scoring dried up here in the third. Nothing that quarter for either side. Back now here on EA Sports. 7-7 is our score. Pretty even matchup so far as we start quarter number four. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. This to break our fourth quarter tie. And his kick here is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get it.
And he will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of 7. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the gun, Sellers forced out to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give him credit. They took their shot. Going to bring up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big play that time through the air, 31 yards. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. He'll look to throw, buying time to his left. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down. A shotgun handoff now, Foster. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking in the point of attack. Look at this little drive going right here.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They run. It's Foster. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here. 3rd and 1 yard. They'll try and run for it with Foster. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? Well, it looked like they were playing for the pass. That was 3rd and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you should have a few men in the box there.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. Here's 2nd and 1 now from the 7. Dixon running from the shotgun, and he is in. Touchdown, Nebraska. A great effort there. With time running out, and the Cornhuskers have taken the lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 14-10. Here's Nebraska now after the touchdown, back out to kick it away. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. The Tiger offense ready to get after it one more time. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. Now they burn the timeout, and they're kind of in that gray area where they might be able to get 2 plays in, but maybe just 1 play left in this ball game. We'll see. Now Taylor. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. One last shot for Taylor. And that will be off target and incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Going for the deep ball. And it's incomplete.
Oh, yeah.
The final drive comes up empty. So celebration time in Lincoln tonight. For the first time in more than two decades, the Nebraska Cornhuskers are on top of the college football world.
Oh, wow, that's fucking cool, I guess.
For all my listeners out.
No matter the game, that is what he aspires to be on and off the field. That competitive edge is something we both share. There's a lot of respect there. You know, I was an athlete forever, and I'm still a cutthroat competitor.
Both of you, the
results from all your performance screenings were off the charts, which we expected. The DNA analysis helped too.
Yeah, you guys don't mess around. Man, I felt like a science experiment or something these last few weeks.
Everything counts. We...
Back in the day, I was broke with no dollar. Now I got Gucci all over my collar.
It's hard knowing other dudes are gonna be. Yeah, I gotta be honest. I didn't expect to answer any questions about my favorite marine mammals. Not really my area of expertise.
Well, this one is a little more straightforward. Teams that pick near the top of the draft are generally concerned with how guys who've had a lot of success in college will handle it if that doesn't come overnight in the NFL.
Obviously, we're picking first overall for a reason. We've got a lot of holes in our roster that we need to fill. So if this is a process that takes some time, how are you going to respond?
I understand this is going to be a process. I'll be walking into a role where I'll be expected to be a leader pretty early on. So my number one priority is to lead by example from day one. Work hard, be a great teammate, and become the best possible player that I can be. And together, in time, we'll turn the franchise around and become the example of organizational greatness in the NFL. Man, my agent warned me that some of these questions would be random. Yesterday, I was asked about my favorite marine mammals, and now you guys got me singing karaoke? Man, I can't believe it.
Well, the good news is, and I don't mean any offense by this, but we know for sure your game tape is better than your singing.
Yeah, well, I'm glad we got that all figured out.
So if you don't mind, I want to go back to your last college season. It goes without saying that you had a prestigious career. But did you feel like you needed to win the national championship to validate it?
No doubt about it. When I made my college decision, I didn't set out to break records or even end up number one pick in the draft. My goal was to win national championships. Winning is all that matters to me.
2 minutes.
It's gonna be good to get back home.
Mm.
Y'all got some good news before you came down.
Your boy graduated, leveled up. Finally got Jordan to pass me her brand connects.
Not all of them.
From now on, I'm gonna be your go-to.
So that's the situation. The Hawaii charity game that Russell Wilson is hosting is the same day as the Nike event in New York City that Zoe is heading to. And no, it's not possible to do both.
Man, that's tough. What do you think, Jay?
Well, the Nike event is a good opportunity to continue building up your brand. But the EA Sports event will help your brand in a completely different way. You know how it goes. I know it's a tricky decision, but that's life in the NFL.
That's what I've been waiting for.
Yeah, I get that. But what I mean is you're always gonna have people pulling you in different directions. And there are only so many hours in a day to do everything.
Yeah, I gotcha.
So, what's it gonna be?
Hit a knee and pray. I go state to state, making plays for that paper plate. I must keep it pure and then secure whatever's meant for me. Throw me to the wolves and I survived it. Now it's hell to pay. I can feel me rising up.
Okay.
Down. I do sit in my bell. Heard you was over here hiding now. I give you something to cry about. Back in
fronts. Licking outside and the flower burn where the garden is. Rush past when they take a turn in the flower bed.
What? Get the fuck out of here with that shit. Rain.
I don't forget. Know they watching, I'ma make them up. I don't forget. I done seen a monster, it's enough now. Skating on thin ice for my trust now. Came from buses to buses to bus now. We are not the same, I was not bound. But you can figure how to hate come to love now. I can't relate, I'm as humble as they come.
Let's talk about all of our sickness. You talk about all of the symptoms. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about being an addiction. Let's talk about dodging the sentence. Let's talk about how I was inflicted with all of the wounds that existed. Giving you pain and infliction. I talk about everything different. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? Shutting it all down. Bringing the world down. What are you talking about?
Yep.
Traffic, then we spill some more. Tea drink down, and then we sit back. And then we put up our feet and make a
a sick track. And I've been cooking for weeks. I made
LA
a big bag. And
LA
I've been
cooking
the seats. I've been cooking for weeks.
Well, you just heard it from the man himself. Life is a bit different now since the last time you wore a Nebraska Cornhuskers uniform.
Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts.
Hey,
slipping once, okay, so
right, put that phone away.
Someone hit your block up.
I'm just messing with you, man. Glad you made it out. Manny Kahue, senior assistant coach here.
Great to meet you, coach. Number, I've heard a lot of great things about you.
Really? You must do your homework. How many assistant coaches are getting love? Thanks for coming out on such short notice. We really wanted to get you in before the draft.
I was excited to come out here. Thanks for having me.
Glad to hear it. All right, coach wanted me to show you around the facility, and then we can get out to the practice field. Sound good?
Let's do it.
All right.
Again? I don't know how I always end up with the Jazz, bro. many seconds was it?
Ready! Nola 7-8! Nola 7-8! Ready, go!
Ain't no way! The fuck you have to do to survive that shit?
Chicago 98! Set, ready, set, hut!
You can't do anything! There ain't no goddamn way in the NFL you survive 7 seconds. Fucking hate y'all. Of course I ain't gonna get no receiver.
Ready?
Well done. Okay, well done.
Cut, cut. Yeah. Okay, break. Cut, go.
Already.
So fucker, but even though he caught it and everything, not good enough. My baby.
As you might expect, we've been keeping up with the various pro days being held at colleges across.
All right, Coach. We'll sync up later on.
It's great to meet you, Coach. Thanks for stopping in.
Well, looks like you're stuck. Hey, man, I don't want you to get a big head or anything, because watching film is the one thing in the world.
Yeah, perfect. We'll definitely be in touch.
We are not only with the projected number one pick of the NFL draft, we are also joined by his agent, Jordan Ryan. You know, you don't see a lot of players sign with a relatively unknown agent. How'd you convince him to sign?
She's more hungry than I am. You need those types of people.
I didn't have to convince him. You know, you've seen it all and heard it all. There was a lot of doubt when he made the announcement, but we knew what the reaction would be.
She just had to be herself. You're just a number out there with some people, but her vision, her path, she's gonna change the game, and I'm committed to making it happen.
Well, she has to be good to get you to sign with Nike. Did they give you the LeBron deal?
We don't disclose numbers.
All right.
Getting him in with Nike was a big deal for me. The greatest athletes in the world are a part of this family. He should be no different.
Yeah, that was definitely one of the biggest you made him moments over the last few months. Mm. There's been a ton of them, no doubt. But getting the chance to take part in this event was a huge deal.
You heard the man. He thinks he's Hall of Fame bound, and I'm certainly not going to provide any opposition to
that. Fucking Jets
if I were betting women, I'd say he'd be returning to Canton someday as a Hall of Famer. I wish you nothing but the best of the draft tomorrow.
This was fun, Nia. Appreciate you.
This is the first time I ever seen you look nervous.
I'm good.
You sure?
I'm good. Just been waiting on it.
Everything's gonna fall into place.
Yeah, man, you the rookie of the year. You haven't even walked across the stage yet.
Can he get picked first?
Oh, everybody in this room know he's gonna be a problem no matter which team drafts him. Missing piece to a championship. Not one, not two, not three.
Can he focus on the draft?
But truthfully, we know you never been a factor. But honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got the boys, got the max up.
from the devil got you piping hot.
The home tab is your personal dashboard. Keep track of...
You've been busy, huh? I thought I'd be stuck in the OTA dorms.
You will be soon, but after OTAs, the keys are all yours.
Yo, this is a real nice spot.
Had to get a...
Pupukai Holomua. I must be in the right place.
Well, you tried. I'm impressed. It's good to see you, though.
Absolutely. I was so pumped when I heard you were interviewing for the defensive coordinator job here. We are going to light it up this year, coach.
Bruh, that's definitely the plan.
Man, and I've been reading through that playbook nonstop ever since.
Play preseason.
Come on, man. They holding out on me in the preseason. I didn't even get a choice.
Hey.
Hey man, now you see why they have you taking it easy throughout the preseason? If you got injured before the season started, every fan out there is immediately right. Hey man, now you see why they have you taking it easy throughout the preseason.
Well, let's see what we can do in the regular season then.
Look, we got dealt a bad hand yesterday. But no team in the league is... Look, we got dealt a bad hand yesterday.
Obvious that you haven't played a single snap in the preseason when you say something foolish like that. The worst team in the NFL will absolutely smoke the best college team every single year.
You ain't changing my mind on this one.
Listen, if you still feel that the competition was tougher in college by after this Sunday, man, dinner is on me. I got you. And vice versa, deal?
Uh-oh. Come on, baby.
Let's go, fellas. On the hop. Who wants it? Let's see some hustle out there today. Got a big game this week. Come on.
Sack 70 Timberwolf. Check out.
Ah, ha, ha, wow, thanks.
Set up! Panther 60, Panther 60! Ready, go!
Somebody's fucking open! If he is open, he drops it. Yeah, he drops it.
Listen up, fellas. I think we all know what today was. Today simply wasn't good enough. We have high aspirations as a team. If we want to get there, we got to raise our game. Today was not good enough. Next practice, I want it better.
Yes, sir, coach. I already tried.
On the ready.
All right, this is it. The gold standard. We are going for gold.
Back again up in this entertain it for you. Come for my aims, you get this double double. Fake to your bubble in this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rubble. You pop pop like my black one. Did you forget? We know you're not with any. What are you doing, baby? Olive, figure it out. What are you doing? Baby, come here. Let go, I got you. Here. Plus times? Jesus. Expect me, that's a lot of throws.
America Stadium in Charlotte, North Carolina. the NFL on EA Sports.
The return man, Ty Johnson. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. And a look here at their go-to guy under center.
And what I'm looking for from him today, the things every quarterback is looking to do. Lead his team to a victory. Doesn't matter whether he's throwing it, running it, handing it off, however he has to do it, as well as exhibiting some leadership, that's what he's trying to accomplish.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six. Charles, we'll take a look there at the draft class for the New York Jets. Robert Saleh, the new head coach. He's got his quarterback as they took Zach Wilson number two and moved Sam Darnold down to Carolina.
And we might end up seeing that Elijah Moore out of Ole Miss taken at number 34 could go down as one of the steals in the draft. The wide receiver was drawing rave reviews as far back as the OTAs. And one other one that we should note, how about how they manipulated the draft, traded at number 14 to take the guard Elijah Vera Tucker out of USC to protect Zach Wilson.
Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Flush to his right. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Some early fireworks from this rookie quarterback getting the start in week one.
And every time a rookie quarterback gets to start week one, you and I both know the extra attention that comes with it. We know that he's going to throw the football, but will he make the right decisions? And in this case, with his legs, he showed the defense there's an extra dynamic to his game.
Well, Carter Landry maybe doesn't have the speed he once had in his Longhorn days, but he showed a nice little burst after that catch.
Almost like he had a little bit of a throwback there, huh, partner? Because while he was never really a burner, he did have the ability to outrun linebackers. And here, as you described, he looked like the 2014 Carter Landry. And he rumbled for a big gain.
On second down, a run with Carter. And he's going to get this down close to a first at about the Jet 16. Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. Off the bootleg, Sellers. He finds Perine out of the backfield. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. A nice completion there for the first down. And Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week one. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have.
That's going to be caught by Crowder. It's a Jets touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Jets are on the board here first in the season opener. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kick. On first down. Sellers flushed out right. Man open is Keelan Cole, complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Another completion there. And we think back to the draft in the spring. This franchise essentially handing him the keys to the operation. A top five pick. Charles, how ready do you think he is?
I think he's ready for the NFL in terms of size, speed, the makeup of him, the character of him. The key's going to be, will this team accept everything he brings to the game and adapt to it, not just necessarily plug him into something that he doesn't do well.
So they say no to the penalty, the incompletion stands, it'll be second and 10.
And what they want to do is go ahead and take those downs away from them. You never want to give extra snaps to any offense. That's how you get hurt.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. Another completion there, and what a big moment in a young quarterback's life, that first NFL start. And Charles, obviously they want him to win games, but if they're looking at him under a microscope in this first month or so, what do you think they're hoping to see from him?
Well, for every question they'll have for him, they should have for themselves as a coaching staff, because it's not just how quickly can he learn the offense, it's what they can teach him, right? How can he build a relationship with his receivers? And of course, how open is he to learning? And of course, how open are they to giving him things that he can put in place on the field?
Now a play fake here on first down. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Out of the gun, they run with Carter. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
A good strong run there by Michael Carter, reminiscent of his days at North Carolina. 1,000-yard rusher each of his last 2 years in Chapel Hill, despite being in a timeshare with Javonte Williams, who was a second-round pick of the Denver Broncos. Carter, the second pick of the fourth round, out of UNC. He could be the Jets' leading rusher moving forward.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Shotgun snap, and a give to Carter. And he's going to get this down close to a first at about the Jets' 18-yard line. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Back to throw. Sellers eluding the pressure right. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
On fourth down, Sellers escaping the pressure right.
Are you fucking kidding me? Get the fuck out of here with that bullshit.
But the fourth down play doesn't...